Hi, my name is Ehsan, and this is the first video I'm publishing on my YouTube channel. This is about research paper, and I have many other ideas that I'd like to share with you because I believe one sentence, one experience from someone that has experienced that can save your time, your money, and everything. So I'm going to start with this video is about research paper, how to write it, and then move to other areas like how to read, all the experiences that I have had, like how to get a job, things like that. So let's see how it goes. This is going to be 31 videos. This is the first video about research paper, and I'm going to go through all of these together. So let's go through the slides. I have created some slides for you. As you can see here, my name is Ehsan. I've been here in the US for 10 years, and people have mispronounced my name, like Ehsan, Ehsan, or things like that. If you can say Ehsan, I'm happy with that, but I found the closest that you can get to my right pronunciation is like Ehsan, just sun, like just the sun in the sky. So if you can say Ehsan, I will be happy with that. All right, now let's go about me. I want to tell you who I am and why I'm sharing this course with you. All right, next slide. I am from Iran. I did my bachelor degree in teaching chemistry for 4 years in Iran. It was not a very famous university. It's called Shahid Rajai Teacher Training University, and that's me. And then I did my master's degree in organic chemistry, and this is my PI for 3 years. And then during those 3 years, I was also a teacher. So I was teaching, and this is the first class that I had, and I was teaching in a remote village in Iran, and it was like 752 miles away from where I was doing the master degree. And it was like a really long trip that I had to do every single week for a year. And that's another story on its own. Then I applied for grad school. I applied for 15 universities, and I got admitted into 5 of them. And I decided to go to University of Florida. That was my acceptance email. And then we packed everything and came to US in 2015, where I did my PhD in chemistry in the Gröning lab. So I came as an inorganic chemistry, and then I changed my major to organic. That's another story. Then when I finished my PhD, it was 3 days before my defense that they told me you have to do it remotely because of all, you know, COVID. And I did that, and you know, on the bright side, this is my family that they are watching my defense, because you know, I was doing that online, so why not? I shared the link with them and they were watching. I'm pretty sure they don't know what I'm talking about, but thanks for your support. And this is my wife, and we met in the bachelor degree those years at university, this Rajai University. She was my classmate, and then she did also a bachelor in chemistry, and then a master in another university in organic chemistry. And then again, we became classmate for the PhD. And then in 2019, I got a job at Intel, and I started in 2020, and I've been there, and I've been at Intel since then. So yeah, this is a short story about me, and this is our little Miu Miu. She's not that little anymore. I will put a new picture later. And we have a boy. His name is Nick. He's 2 years now that I'm recording these videos, and this is me at ACS. All right, so this was a little story about me. As I said, I've been teaching in Iran. I started from the south part of Iran. So let me zoom here. So I was here and then moved to the capital, and then went to Tabriz, which is like a city in the northwest of the Iran. And then we came to the US. So we went to University of Florida in Gainesville. And then after 5 years, we moved to Portland, where Intel is located. And I drove actually from Gainesville to Portland in 8 days. That was a journey that I will share with you later. So now, this was about me. I want to say a little bit about like why I'm doing this. So why you have to listen to me for research paper, how to write it. I have been the author for research papers, and I also have been reviewers for many journals. So this is my portfolio, my Google Scholar basically. I have published 20 papers and my H index is 13. This might go up. So I'm recording this in 2025. So I have published many papers. I have good, I'm not going to say excellent, but I have a good H index, which I will explain later what is H index. So during my bachelor degree, I had no paper. Then during my master degree, I published 3. And then after that, there was a gap. So I was teaching in high school and I graduated basically from my my master degree, but I had to fill that gap. So I was doing research and I was able to publish 13 papers during those 5 years. And then I got admitted into the UF and then had 4 papers there plus 1 US patent. And of course, no paper after getting the job. And this is the list of the journals that I have been reviewer for. So it was a lot of, I don't recall the exact number, but more than 40 or 50 papers I have been doing the review for. What's the motivation behind this course? So I have had many people asking me, how do we can write papers? We have had experience, how do we can do it? And now, because many people have like, you know, they have different majors, they have different discipline, and I didn't know how to explain it so it makes sense for everyone. And one day, idea came to my mind that I said, okay, I'm gonna pick one example, one very generic example, and I'm gonna go through this course with you and reference that simple example through the course. So it will make sense for everyone with any major. It might be some, you know, corner cases that it's different, or so you might say, oh, in my discipline it's different. Yes. So it's really hard to do that, to explain something that is applicable to everyone. So it's hard. But I will do my best to do that. So I said, okay, I'm going to go through this course with you with that example, because I think that is useful. And next slide, the target audience. So who has to watch these videos? I would say if you are a high school student, probably these videos will not be useful for you. And then if you are a bachelor student, again, I would say it might be useful to know what's ahead of you, what comes to you later, if you want to stay, you know, and continue your degree to, you know, go to master or PhD. This is going to be useful. But in the US, you know, in different countries, they have different, you know, rules and, you know, things for bachelor degree. But in the US, usually people do some undergrad research assistant thing. So it's like one undergrad goes to a research lab and works with the PhD students before applying for grad school. And that's just a part of his or her resume to apply for grad school. and they do not need to know how to write a research paper. But of course, if they know, that's a plus for them when they apply for grad school. Then if you are a grad student, if you are a master degree student or PhD, you must know how to write a research paper. And in it really, again, it depends on your research lab. Some PIs wants you to write the research paper. Some of them, they don't. You are off the hook. You can do the research. But still, in some countries, I'm pretty sure you have to know how to write a research paper. You have to write it on your own. Some research lab in the US also, the PI might push you to write the research paper. So this is going to be useful. But what if you are a PI and watching these videos? I would say you can share this video with your team. If they do not know how to write a research paper, this is going to be useful for them for sure. And I'm going to, you know, tell you, when they watch these videos, you don't have to explain or over explain something to them, because I have went through all the steps to have a close to publication. You might also have your own touches, but it's gonna be a good start if they watch these videos. And again, this is a free course. You can go through all of these videos for free. I could put this course on, you know, these websites that they, you know, keep you behind a paywall to pay and watch them. But I want this course to be free for everyone. So if it's useful to you, please share it with others, and we can go from there. And subscribe for more videos. Yeah. So the sections of this course, I have prepared 31 videos for you, and this one was the first one. It was an introduction about me, about why I'm doing this, the motivation, who is the target audience. And then in the next video, I'm gonna go through why is publishing a research paper is important. And as you can see, there are 31 videos. So just bear with me. Maybe the first couple of videos are boring because you already know, and you might say, oh, why do I should know you? Because maybe in the future someone says, oh, why it finds video number 20 and it says, why I have to listen to this guy, this random guy on the YouTube? so he or she can go back to the first video, watch it, and say, oh, okay, so that makes sense. You have 20 papers, you have done reviews, so you know at least something. And of course, people have different knowledge about research paper writing, and some of these videos might make sense for them. Some of them they already know, and some of them they may don't know. So I have to assume you don't know anything. That's why I'm starting from the scratch. All right, so now, yeah, that's all the 31 videos that I will go through. And one last question. Can you write a research paper after watching all of these videos? Well, it really depends. I do not want to say yes, for sure you can, because to me, writing the research paper is the easiest part. The most important part is having the idea and then put that idea into work and make sure that is working. But I would say that if you watch all of these 31 videos, you do not need to watch any single video about how to write research paper, because I'm gonna go through everything that you can imagine, every single step. And these are all my own firsthand experience, and I'm teaching all of these to you in a simple way, hopefully. Yeah, and that's it for this video. In the next video, I'm gonna share with you, why is publishing a research paper important? Why do you have to publish a research paper? People may have this question. All right, until next video, bye.